Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and good morning all of you. This is Ashima and in this video we'll be talking about Delhi current affairs, where we'll be talking about various news events that have happened in the past day. But before we begin, since this is going to be a more descriptive form so that more news events are reached out to you in the lesser time possible with all the important points for examination covered, but sometimes we also need questions for practice, right? So for that purpose, we have everyday live quiz which happens on Entry app. So you can download the app from Google Play Store, for which the link is available in the comment section below, right? Or in the description section also it's available. You can check out on that link, download the app and give this live quiz, which is completely free of cost. Apart from that, we also have a free mocks that are running right now on the app. So you can download the app and get free mocks also. And you don't have to pay anything, you just have to do the registration process and you'll get all the mocks free of cost. And the best thing about this app is that you will get it in multiple languages. That is, you have an option to choose from various languages that we have, including all the regional languages. Right, so apart from Hindi, English, we also have Urdu, Telugu, Malayalam, Tamil and Marathi. Urdu, all of these languages are available. So you just need to download the app and avail the benefits. Now we'll be beginning with the discussion on news events. The first one which we're going to talk about is Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Nidhi. So what do we have in this Nidhi or fund that has been created? So this is a single non-lapsable reserve fund that has been created by the Government of India and it has been approved as a non-lapsable fund for the share of health from the health and education cess levied under section 136B of Finance Act 2007. So it is for the share of health from the health and education cess. Now revenue will be used for what purposes? So what is the purpose why this fund has been created? So all the revenue that is generated in this, it is going to be used for schemes of health ministry, which includes National Health Mission, which has been ongoing and was announced in the budget as well. And Ayushman Bharat Health and Wellness Center, Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, emergency situations like we had this, you know, a flu that ran out of nowhere, pandemic that ran out of nowhere. So for the emergency situations also, for disaster preparedness also, that is in case any calamity happens and medical preparedness is required for that also, and for all the health emergency cases that are there. So this has been created all for health sector, and therefore now you can guess which ministry is going to undertake it. So Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is going to take care of this fund, or it is going to manage the fund for all the healthcare services so that the amount does not lapse at the end of the year. Right, now the next set of information is Insurance Act 1938, which has been amended recently. Now this amendment has come to force recently, under which, first of all, who has approved it? This amendment has been approved by Union Cabinet recently. That's why it has been news. Now, what are the amendments that have been ensured in this? First of all, FDI limit, as you had seen in the budget, it was increased to 74% for all the insurance sector, and life insurance also, and in general also. So in the insurance video that we have on the channel, a video on all the types of insurance I've already covered in the video. You can check out on the channel. Now in India, we have two types of insurance. One is general insurance, one is life insurance. And this is for both types of insurance that 74% of FDI is allowed. How much FDI was allowed earlier? 49% was allowed earlier. And this has been increased to 74% now. Right. Now, has it been, directly... Initially, was it 49%? No. Initially, it was 26%. In 2015, it had become 49%. And then after that, it has become 74% now. Right? Apart from that, in insurance sector, we already have one amendment, that is for insurance intermediaries. Now, here, don't confuse it. For insurance, it is 74%. But for insurance intermediaries, और इंश्योरेंस इंटरमीडियरीज वी हैव 100% इंश्योरेंस एक्टिव. सो 100% एफडीआई इज इन इंटरमीडियरीज, वेयर इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर हैज 74%. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स ऑन द बोर्ड ऑफ इंश्योरेंस एंड द की मैनेजमेंट पर्संस ऑफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनीज, दे वुड बी they have to be resident Indians, and 50% of directors need to be independent directors in that board. This is a mandatory requirement that has been put forward in this amendment, right? So what do we have about BRICS? So first meeting of BRICS contact group on economic and trade issues was held recently, and this year the theme was BRICS at 15, intra-BRICS cooperation for continuity, consolidation and consensus. The chairship, now you need to remember that for BRICS 2021, chairmanship is with India, or chairship is with India. Therefore, all the meetings that are held, all the summits that are held, all of them are going to be held in India, are going to be hosted by India. Right, so this meeting was also hosted by India only. Then a few one-liners. West Bengal has the highest number of beggars, while Lakshadweep merely has two. So now you can see what you have over here is which state has the highest number of beggars as per the census 2011. We have conducted the survey. So West Bengal has the highest and Lakshadweep has the least amount, that is hardly two. Then Bangladesh is going to celebrate the birth centenary of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, golden jubilee of liberation of country. And this is what you need to follow up is Sheikh Mujibur Rahman is known as father of the nation of Bangladesh, just like we have Mahatma Gandhi as the father of nation of India. Now Sheikh Mujibur Rahman has been the prime minister of Bangladesh, he has been the president of Bangladesh, and in his name this year United Nations also created an award on creative economy. Right, then Indian American Madhu Varghese has been appointed as director of White House Military Office. From appointments section, you need to remember that the question that you're going to receive is going to involve a direct question. There won't be any intermediary steps of that question. This is going to be a direct question for you. Who has been appointed to this position, or this person has been appointed at which position? Any which ways. Then IT services firm Wipro has appointed Pierre Bruno as chief executive officer or CEO of European operations. Right, this is less of an important one because it involves European operations. Then Ministry of State for Finance and Corporate Affairs, Anurag Thakur, has been promoted as Captain in Territorial Army. So he is a minister already, and now he has been appointed as the Captain of Territorial Army also as a regular commissioned officer, right? Then World Bank has recently published its report. Now the name of the report is Connecting to Thrive, Challenges and Opportunities of Transport Integration in Eastern South Asia. So this report has been created by whom? By World Bank. And as per the report, if connectivity of India and Bangladesh is improved, then it is going to help enhance the national income of both the nations. So over here it is important what our relations are going on with India and Bangladesh, especially after being that Maitri Setu which is being built. So Maitri Setu was recently set up foundational stone for, and this is going to be built between India and Bangladesh. In India, it is Tripura which is involved, which will make Tripura as the gateway of India also for the northeast segment. Then world's largest floating power plant, 600 megawatt solar power plant, floating solar power plant. It is going to be constructed at Omkareshwar Dam on which river? Narmada River. Where? In Madhya Pradesh. And it is going to start the generation of electricity by the year 2022-23. Then Amrit Mahotsav is going to start on 12th of March, and this is going to mark the 75 years of India's independence. Now there is already a huge celebration that is going on. There's a huge committee that has been formed. So it has been nicknamed as Amrit Mahotsav, and for this 269 members committee has already been instituted, which is being headed by the Prime Minister of India for checking out what 75 years of independence celebration should involve. So what is going to happen in this Amrit Mahotsav? 75 locations, 75 weeks celebrations are going to be organized in the country, and it is going to involve the past, present, future of the country. That is, a theme has been set in such a way that we study about what has been the past, the freedom struggles, the present, what we have done, the future, what do we aim to. Then government appointed GP Samantha as the new chief statistician of India. Again, an appointment question. You should know about the statistical department of India. Then Reserve Bank of India has removed IDBI Bank from the Prompt Corrective Action or PCA framework, which is the enhanced regulatory supervision of RBI, and this was created under Banking Act for keeping an eye on all the banks which are going down or which are facing losses. So for them, whenever a bank is facing a loss, they go under a PCA, Prompt Corrective Action, and IDBI has been in that for the past 4 years, but finally it has started showing a consistent growth and therefore it has been removed from the PCA. Then UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has inaugurated Razin Dam and Chilimalai Dam, both of them in Chitrakoot. Narendra Modi ji is going to participate in the first leaders summit of Quad, and in this leaders summit, earlier it was only foreign ministers meet. So if you talk about the last meeting that was held, the last meeting was held in Japan and that was a foreign ministers meeting. But now for the first time, leaders summit is being organized of Quad countries, and therefore all the leaders are going to be there. For Australia, it is going to be Scott Morrison who will be attending. Prime Minister of Japan Yoshinide Suga is going to attend. Prime Minister, President of USA Joseph R. Biden or Joe Biden is going to attend, and from India it is going to be the Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi. The world's most powerful supercomputer Fugaku is all ready to use now. Then IBM has signed an MOU with Uttarakhand government to introduce STEM subjects and STEM stream for girls. But STEM is something which is not much promoted in girls. What is a STEM? That is science, technology, engineering and mathematics. These subjects are the ones which girls usually don't prefer or are not favored to take these. But now an MOU has been signed with Uttarakhand government for promoting STEM subjects in girls, and this is between IBM and Uttarakhand government. Apart from that, government itself is also doing a lot of things, and a lot of projects have been launched so that STEM subjects can be promoted among the girl child. Then World Kidney Day was observed on 11th of March, and this year the theme was Living Well with Kidney Disease. Then Narendra Modi ji had flagged off a 91st anniversary of Dandi March on March 12th in Ahmedabad for the celebration of 75 years of independence. Right? Then Bareilly Airport has begun its operations in UP, and now after this, 8th airport of UP is Bareilly Airport, and after it has become the 8th airport, UP has become the first state of India to have the maximum number of airports. Right? Then Paradip Plastic Park of Odisha, for that purpose an MOU has been signed with Indian Oil Corporation Limited IOCL and Odisha Industries Infrastructure Development IDCO. So both of them have tied up an agreement with Paradip for setting up a Paradip Plastic Park. And in plastic terms, we also need to remember that the first plastic laptop has been created. And who has created that? HP created the first laptop made of plastic. Ocean plastic has been used in that. Then Magic Bricks, Razorpay and HDFC Bank, all three have partnered to develop a secure online solution, PayRent. And this is for all the rent payments through credit card. So this it's important that who has partnered: Magic Bricks, Razorpay and HDFC Bank. Then CAT has launched vendor onboarding mobile app Bharat eMarket, which is going to bring vendors online or bringing them on the online platform. PLI scheme, production linked incentive scheme. We have all heard about this scheme, and for this the base year is 2019-20, and if the manufacturing in the sectors which are already included in PLI scheme, if any sectors included in that and they see an upsurge in manufacturing, then government provides them with incentive, right? So for pharmaceuticals, PLI inclusion of pharmaceuticals has been approved by Chemicals and Fertilizers Ministry. Then central government has launched Mera Rashan mobile app for, and this has been launched in association with National Informatics Center. Now what is going to happen is, this is going to, like, we already have one nation, one ration card policy which is going on, which government is promoting. That is that single ration card all over India is going to be valid. And anyone, maybe a migrant worker, you're living at some place, you have a ration card of some place, then you can avail the facilities of ration card in that particular city you're living in, because that is a one nation, one ration card, or a single ration card for whole country. Right. So in line with that, we have Mera Ration mobile app, which has been launched, and promoting the same lines. Then Uttar Pradesh government has ordered to remove all the religious structures on public roads. Maithili Raj has become the first Indian women cricketer to score 10,000 international runs. And Niti Aayog has submitted the first list of 12 public sector undertakings that are going to be privatized. Now, we already know about the banks being privatized. Two are supposed to be privatized. One, General Insurance Company, IDBI. And now, in public sector undertaking also, disinvestment is going to be done. So, for disinvestment in the sector of public sector undertakings of PSUs, 12 PSUs have been identified, and this is the first list. It is going to be reviewed definitely, and if approved, these from these PSUs also government is going to withdraw its amount or disinvest. Then we have European Parliament, which has declared whole of the European Union as LGBTIQ freedom zone. That is, that whole European Union is completely free for all the LGBTIQ people to live freely, independently, as they want, how they want. No European country is going to ban it, because it's a union, and when a union decision comes, then all the individual countries' decisions become null and void on that part, unless someone is completely opposed to it or they have their reasons. So, in Poland, this whole issue was going on, but now European Parliament has declared that European Union as a whole has become LGBTIQ freedom zone. No discrimination would be allowed. Then Japanese Australian venture has started producing hydrogen from brown coal. Now Japan and Australia, both of them have collaborated for this project, and it's about 500 million pilot project which has been approved recently. Right? Now, with this, I'll be taking your leave. Do like the video and share the video to the maximum possible. Also, do comment if you have any doubt or if you face any issue in the video. You can put them in the comment section. They will be tended to. Also, you can check out the app for which the link has been put down in the comment section below. You can check the app out and take free quizzes, free mocks and live quizzes over there. So, see you soon with the fresh set of questions. Until then, goodbye, take care and have a wonderful day ahead.